strong focus on what I want.
I'm back. What's up, boys? Thanks for 450 subs.
Thank you!
Thanks. I mean, thanks. Despite of all positive comments in my previous Valorant video, there are so many people commented that they're getting stutters in the game, getting FPS drops, and majority of them was stuck at loading screen or freezing screen problem. So first of all, I want to say that I'm not a god, okay? Sorry. So instead of exact solution, I can only show you some steps which can possibly fix this problem. So let's get started. So the first is, if you have an SSD, I mean solid state drive, make sure you have installed the game in your SSD. If you don't know what's your SSD, it's normally your local disk C. That's not going to increase your FPS, but that will decrease the loading time for that. In some cases, it will solve the freezed loading screen problem. Make sure you have a decent stable network speed, I mean network connection, around 500 kbps minimum. And if you're running with a laptop, I strongly suggest to use this separate port that comes with your laptop. Yeah, this one. Just throw the Ethernet cable into it. I mean, use the Ethernet instead of the Wi-Fi. So for some people, it can be a game changer, but for some people, it will be same as before. But theoretically, that should increase your performance. Now head over to the search bar, search for %appdata%, and hit enter. Then go to the app data, then open the local. And find the file named Valorant there, then open saved, then open this config file and open this number file. It's weird kind of looking file. Then open Windows, game settings, and open it with your notepad. For those who haven't seen my previous Valorant video, I'm showing this thing again with a little bit modification. So I strongly suggest you to follow that video first. If that somehow doesn't work for you, then try these modifications, and this should fix that freeze loading screen problem and other stuttering. So do the same as before, like foliage quality 0, FX quality 0, texture quality 0, post process quality 0, shadow quality 0, anti-aliasing 0, and view distance quality to 1. Now here comes the resolution value. This portion is kinda trickier. If you're having a mid to high end PC and you're getting like around 90 plus FPS but you're getting this loading screen problem, then set this resolution value to 90. For those who have a low end PC, just put this value between 10 to 40. And for ultra low end dirt cheap PC, you have to put this number between 0 to 10. Now, as I don't know your exact specs, you have to play around with this number according to this table to find the sweet point for your PC. Now, for example, if you have a low-end PC and you have put the value to 40 and it's not working, you are getting stutters. So put the value to 20 and try again, and such kind of like that. Now head over to the top and go to file and hit save. Don't forget to save it. Double check it if you have saved it or not. Now cut the notepad, right click on it, go to the properties, and in the attributes check the box to read only and apply and okay. Now let's jump onto the in-game settings. Don't forget to change the resolution in in-game settings according to your specs, you know what I mean? Also change the graphics. For low end PCs, set this all to low, this to off, and aliasing to none, an isotropic filter to 1x, and turn this all off. For those having Nvidia graphics, you can set your optimal settings from GeForce Now Experience. Anyways, for low end PC, just go with these settings. Last but not the least, go to the search bar, type power, and you will find choose power plan. Just select it, and you will get these kind of options. Now, if you have ultimate power performance option, then you can go with ultimate, but I recommend to go with the high performance, and this kind of works somehow sometimes. Just give it a shot. Also, big shout out to Yubi for reminding me this thing in my last stream. That's all I got for you today. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Comment me if this video was helpful to you, and at least subscribe. And also, this kind of video takes way more time to edit than you think, so please give a like. And don't forget to comment and let me know if it worked or not. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being with me in my darkest time of my life. And thanks for supporting me. Thank you. Thank you for everything, man. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Hope you have having a nice day. Good night. Good luck. See ya in next video. Bye-bye. Subscribe!